Hey, piriformis stretch. Bolster. Maybe something higher. Maybe something smaller. Depends how flexible. So bring it long ways for me. I'm going to go off on this kind of angle for you. I'm going to sit long ways along the bolster. I usually rotate it round to its unsquashes part, so it's at the highest part. Capture it. Make sure my knee is over the front edge of the bolster, and then make sure my shin is at a right angle. Sometimes it's good to line yourself up with a yoga mat or a square in the room that can give you that sense. Sometimes we think it's 90, it's not. Bring your back leg back and round. So I'm just going to edge the inside of that leg towards the bolster. If it feels like I'm more flexible, I can move or start to move that bolster just a little bit more out of the way so that I can get back further and around, because that's always going to make it stronger. Check in with the foot. Really important that the ankle is lined up. Just common to just roll into the ankle and the joint just collapse onto the floor. That's going to compromise our stretch. So we need to line all those joints up. I'm trying to get into the glute. So come onto the blade edge of the foot and check that the foot is at a right angle and it's really stable. It's in a neutral position. We're going to use this as one of the contractions as well. So when I first get into these positions, have a bit of a wiggle around, check in with what the hips are feeling like. Notice any areas that are feeling particularly tight, particularly sharp, uneasy, a bit pointy, maybe, I don't know, just depending on how it's feeling. It maybe it's too high, maybe it's too low, so maybe at this point you can go and get something more to lift yourself up if you're having trouble getting that back leg round. Mostly in yoga we will often tip forwards in king pigeon doing this pose. We're heading off towards our foot in this one. The three contractions we're going to do are firstly the knee. So elbow into knee, and I'm just going to take some time to work pushing my knee, jig down towards the ground. So just opening up through that hip and pelvis. Again, you know, position of body isn't necessarily a reflection of how loose the pelvis is. So it's a moving of the pelvis. So you're thinking of lifting through the chest, anchor the elbow into the knee. When you're ready, start gently. Push the knee up into the elbow. And just start to increase it so it builds its intensity up to a good 90-100%. And then 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stop the contraction. Just completely relax. Big breath in and see if you can just draw that knee down a little bit further. Beautiful. Keep the chest lifted. Other contraction is knee downwards. Sometimes I put my hand there just so I feel like I've got something to work against once I've discovered what muscles it feels like I'm using. I don't necessarily have to have my hand, especially when I get into end range and I'm wanting to do that contraction and I don't have a hand there. So good to put the hand there to start with, just so that you've got some resistance and so you've got that sensation of the muscles trying to work. Feels like I haven't got much strength there. Same thing again, you start gently, hold that stretch. Count to 5. Completely stop, big inhale. Start heading towards the blade edge of the foot. Think of sticking the tailbone out. Think of lifting the chest. We're trying to move the pelvis here, not necessarily the upper body. Next one's the blade edge of the foot. So checking that you're at a 90 degree angle in line with the shin. Start gently. This makes kind of everything work for me. And then start to give it as much effort where you feel like you're giving just about 90 to 100% of strength in that joint at that range, that's comfortable for you, and stop. Big breath in and see if you can keep bringing yourself over. Keep going for that edge. Find the edge. Do another round of contractions. Even at this point, you can gently try and lift the knee up. You can feel the muscle working. Relax. You can push the knee downwards. You feel it. Stop. Blade edge of the foot. Lift the pelvis. So we're constantly trying to take that pelvis into a position where we can get closer. So I want you to go to that end range. I want you to stay there. I want you to breathe, even though it feels like you can't take much more. Just breathe and say, it's okay. I'm not ripping any muscles off any bones today. No one's sitting on you yet. And when you're ready to come out of it, use the hands to walk yourself back. And again, bailing, I'm big on, if I can't quite, especially if I've got a bolster, because it's just perfect to have something under your knees to come down and take a little break before you go for a walk. So let that hip have a little relax. Bring yourself up, try and not use that muscle. Use the hands almost to lift you up onto the feet and take yourself for a little walk around, see what it feels like in that hip, and then we'll come back and we'll do the same thing on the other side. And again, looking for asymmetry, looking for the difference, looking for the sensations that feel different in different areas. Excellent.